Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this Photoshop tutorial, I will show you how to make comic-style 3D text using Photoshop's 3D capabilities. I needed a heading for a map art tutorial I am making for Metropolis, Illinois, using a comic art style. I thought a heading in the style of the Superman text would be a good idea, so here is how I did it. Open up a new screen in Photoshop. Name it Metro 3D. I had a 4,000 by 4,000 pixel project at 300 pixels per inch, so I used those settings. Fill it with a light blue color. Click Create. Choose the Type tool. I used Impact Font. Set it 100 points strong. The center text option should be active. Click the text color box and choose F3C E3B, a yellow color. Open the character panel. If you don't have one, choose Window, Character. The leading should be 96 points. Make sure the tracking is set to 0. The horizontal scale should be set to 100%. The vertical scale should be set to 100%. Move to about the center of the upper canvas. Type in Metropolis in all caps. Press Enter and type in Illinois in small case, with a capital I at the beginning as shown. Select just the M at the beginning of Metropolis. Change the font size to 120 points. In the character panel, set the baseline shift to minus 6. Click the big check mark. Select the Move tool. Control T to open the Transform tool. Click the Warp button. Select the arch from the drop-down. Change the bend to 15 degrees. H to minus 20 degrees. And V to minus 5 degrees. Click the big check mark to accept. Next, to center the text, press Control A to select all. Click the Align Vertical Centers tool in the settings. Then click the Align Horizontal tool. Deselect. Choose the Hand tool to turn off the Move tool. Next, to create the 3D text. With the Metropolis text layer selected, from the menu, choose 3D, New 3D Extrusion from selected layer. Click Yes to switch to 3D space. If you don't have a Properties panel, choose Window Properties from the menu. First, to adjust the infinite light. In the 3D panel, select Infinite Light. In the Property panel, turn off the Shadow Property box. Also change the color intensity to 99%. To set the angle of the light, drag the handle to the approximate placement shown. Or you can use My Settings by clicking the coordinates icon and making the middle column 5.7, 23.7, and minus 47.2 degrees, as shown. Click the Environment icon. To remove the IBL shadow, in the Property panel, click the Environment icon. Turn off the shadow in the Property box. In the 3D panel, choose the Metropolis object. In the Properties panel, adjust the extrusion to 832 pixels. Choose the Coordinates icon. If there is anything in the middle column besides zeros, click Reset Coordinates. Here are the coordinates to enter in the middle column. X, minus 15.8, Y, 18.8, and Z, minus 3.4. Now use the Roll tool to roll the text to the left as shown. In the 3D panel, choose the Metropolis front bevel material. That's the second material. Then hold down Shift and choose the Metropolis back inflation material. Now all materials except the front inflation are selected. In the Material Properties box, choose the Diffuse Color box. My color settings were H0, S100, B100, R255, G0, and B0. Press OK to accept. Choose the current view. Add a stroke layer style to the text layer. Size 8, outside, color of black. Move to the Metropolis object. Press Ctrl Alt plus J to duplicate the text layer. Name it Stroke. Right-click and choose Blending Options. Then press OK. In the 3D panel, choose the Metropolis object. In the Properties panel, change the extrusion depth to 1 and press Enter. This will add another stroke to the text object. Now we will render both the Metropolis and the stroke layers. Select the stroke layer in the Layers panel. In the 3D panel, also rename the object name to Stroke. Turn off the blue background layer. Choose the Hand tool to exit 3D space. Choose the Marquee Selection tool and draw a box of marching ants around the logo. Choose Edit Preferences 3D and change High Quality Threshold to 3. If you have it any higher, it will take longer than necessary for this object to render. Click the Render icon at the bottom of the Properties panel. Once done rendering, choose the original Metropolis layer. Choose the Metropolis Illinois object and render it. When it is rendered, hold down Ctrl or Command and select the stroke layer. Now both layers are selected. Right-click and convert to Smart Object. Now you have a flattened copy of the renders. Right-click and choose Export As. Make sure the format is PNG. Click Export All. Give it a name and put it in your project directory. Ctrl-Alt-Z to undo. Deselect. Choose the top layer. In the 3D panel, click the icon to the left of the stroke object. Save your work for safety. At this point, we have finished the Metropolis 3D text. Because we only used text and text warp in our original document, we can use the Metropolis PSD as a template for additional words. So in this case, we will make 3D text for the phrase super duper text. Open the PSD file you just saved. Right-click the stroke layer and choose Delete Layer. Rename the Metropolis layer to super duper. Rename the Metropolis 3D object to super duper. In the Properties panel, choose Edit Source. Type in super duper, enter return, then type in the text as shown. Click the big check mark to accept. Now choose File, Save to save the PSB file. Close the PSB file. Right-click the super duper layer and choose Duplicate Layer. Name it Stroke. Right-click and choose Blending Options, then press OK. In the 3D panel, choose the super duper object. In the Properties box, change the extrusion depth to 1 pixel. Press Enter. Now you can follow the same procedure as you did before with the Metropolis Illinois text. Here is the final super duper ping image placed on a blue background. Here is the final Metropolis Illinois ping image placed on a blue background. Coming soon, Metropolis Illinois map art using the comic map style.